morning children, welcome back with the next new session. I hope you have all understood the previous lesson of early civilization well. So today's topic is also an history topic that we are going to discuss. So the lesson what we are going to deal is lesson number 7, emergence of kingdoms and republic. Lesson number 7, emergence of kingdoms and republic. Okay, emergence of kingdoms and republics. So in this lesson 7, emergence of kingdoms and republics, we are going to learn about a kingdom, or you can say a group of kingdoms together, a group of villages or cities together. Okay, so here also we are going to talk about some 2000 or 3000 years ago, what has happened, what kingdoms were there, how people used to live, or what are the things they used. Okay, so all these things, how we can know all these things, we are going to learn in this part of the lesson. Okay, so the lesson is emergence of kingdoms and republics, that means how the new kingdoms have come. Okay, where did they settle. Okay, everything we are going to learn in this part of the lesson. So firstly, when I talk about this part of lesson, emergence of kingdoms and republics, so I've told that we are going to talk about some 2700 years ago. Okay, so this is a concept of some 2700 years ago concept. So here, so this time is Ganges Valley. Okay, so what is Ganges Valley? In the lesson itself, I'll tell you what is Ganges Valley. So Ganges Valley, it is of about 2700 years ago. Okay, so this Ganges Valley is divided into again of two parts. One is of cities and other is new religious concepts. One is cities and another is two religious concepts. That means the Ganges Valley, that means the place was known by the player. That means how can we know about these places is because of these parts only. That means one part we are going to learn from the cities. That means we can now complete in detail about the Ganges Valley from the cities and other from the other new religious concepts that have come. Okay, now from the cities we have administration. Okay, as cities are there, cities has to be administrated. That means it has to be perfectly ruled or perfectly, they have to look after for the welfare of the people. So administration, and finally again in this administration we have, one is kingdoms, again in this administration we have kingdoms, and other is Gana Sanghas. Gana, G-A-N-A, Gana Sanghas. Okay, so just have a clear look children. So Ganges or the Ganga Valley, it is about 2700 years ago we are going to talk about. So to know the history of this particular Ganges Valley, so we have to know about the cities that are there in this Ganges Valley. Okay, so about the detail about this Ganges Valley, we'll know from the information we'll get from the cities as well as the new religions was there that time. Okay, so let us first talk about the cities only first. Okay, there were some cities, they were the administration. Like for example, in our school we have some administration, isn't it? The staff. Okay, for example, the working staff down the account section. Okay, there is a person who is working with the computers there. There is a person who is looking after all collecting of fees and collecting fines, everything, issuing of books. Okay, collecting money for the books fees, bus fees, every fees. There will be people who are collecting, no? So they are the people who are looking after the schools. Okay, so that work is known as administration. So in the same way, to look after the cities or to look after every city, a small town and a village, there are some people who are looking after. Okay, that means to look after for the welfare of the people, the needs of the people, the requirements of the people. So that is known as administration. Now again, this administration will be in two places. Where do we find the administration? One is in the kingdom. Yes, I told this there are many kingdoms or there are many places. So there also there are some administration. That means every school, for example, every school has their own administration, isn't it? That in the same way, different kingdoms in the Ganges Valley has different administrations. And we will learn about Gana Sanghas. Now, who are Ganas? We'll all learn in detail in this lesson. Okay. Now, when we talk about the new religions, that time during 2700 years ago, the new religions that have come are the Jainism, okay, the Buddhism, the Buddhism, and some other religions, okay. I'm just writing over congested. I'll just tell you in clear. Okay, in the new religions, we have Jainism, we have Buddhism, and there are some other religions. Okay, so in detail, we are going to learn today in this topic, in this session, we are going to learn about the city or the administration or the kingdoms over this part of the lesson. Okay, so firstly, I'll show you a picture of the time that I'm going to speak about today. Okay, so this is a beautiful image that the city we are going to talk about today. Just have a look of the picture here, how beautifully the walls and all are beautifully carved with different architecture. How beautiful it is all designed. So it is a part of the Ganges Valley. So now the Ganges Valley is, we'll be talking about one of the group of villages or group of towns together, that is Mahajanapadas. Okay, I'll just erase this part so that clearly you will understand. Okay, we are going to talk about today Mahajanapadas. Okay, so under Mahajanapadas only we will have cities, and the other side we have, yes, new religious concepts. Okay, so again in the cities, again we'll find administration, and again we have administration is again seen in two places. One, we see administration in kingdom. Yes, every kingdom has its own administration. So kingdom, and other is Gana Sangham. Okay, Gana Sangham. Okay. And here new religious is again divided into three. One is Jainism, other is Buddhism, and there are some other religions. So in this part of the lesson, we are going to clearly talk only about the Mahajanapadas. Firstly, we'll talk about the sacred rivers, the holy rivers that we have in India. The river Ganga and the river Yamuna are the holy rivers that flows right from the Himalayas and come down towards the east, and finally the river gets end into the Bay of Bengal. Okay, the holy rivers of Ganga and Yamuna starts from the laps of Himalayas. That means starts from the Himalayas, the mountain ranges of Himalayas, passes from the different places, and finally towards the east direction it moves, and finally it goes into and mixes into the Bay of Bengal. Okay, so when it comes from the Himalayas, it will be traveling into different places. Okay, different hills and different mountains it will all cross. So when it is coming from its way, that means when the water is flowing right from the Himalayas, it has to pass some mountains, it has to pass some hills. So when it is coming down from For example, I'll just show you. Okay. Okay, so if it starts from the Himalayas, it starts coming towards the east direction, and finally it meets up into Bay of Bengal. So when it is coming down from the direction to the Bay of Bengal towards the east, so it meets on its way, it also meets some of the places. So in these some places, they will have some mountains or they may find some hills also. So when coming from Himalayas direct to the Bay of Bengal, in between when the water is flowing, they also carry some kind of a mud or some kind of a sand. Okay, some mud or some kind of a sand. So these mud or sand, that is known as silt. Silt. Okay, it is known as silt. S-I-L-T. Silt. So silt is nothing but the fertile soil that is deposited on the banks of the rivers. In the previous lesson I have told, so whenever the rivers are flowing, for example I told about the example of river Godavari. So if you stand on the banks of river Godavari, we will see the water pushes all the mud towards the edges. That means the place where we stand, no, that is known as the banks. Okay, so whatever the water brings all the soil towards the ends. Okay, so when it is keeping all the soil towards the end, what is happening? The area where this mud is collected, that soil is known as fertile soil. That soil is known as fertile soil. Now, fertile soil is very good for agriculture. As we have discussed in our previous lessons, that fertile soil is very much good for growing crops or any kind of like food grains, especially food grains like paddy, food grains like wheat and rice grows very well with the fertile soil. Now, so when this river Ganga and when this river Yamuna is bringing all the sand or silt towards the places of these places, people who were there in Mahajanapadas, people who were there in Mahajanapadas, that means people who were there in Mahajanapadas, so they used to use this soil to grow the crops there, especially the crops of paddy, especially the crops of wheat and rice. So the people, that means the farmers, usually farmers grow the crops, no? So the farmers in that time were tribal people. So not like farmers how we have it present days. They were tribal people. Now, the tribal people means, that means they will not have the proper area to do the agriculture, isn't it? What they will have? They will have a forest land. So what they will do? See, in the lesson of early life to settled life, I told. So a land, in the forest land, what they will do? They will clear the land, they will level the land. After clearing all the waste crops, they will level the land and then they sow some seeds or saplings. Isn't it? I told. Isn't it? In the same way, here the farmers are no one, but they are the tribal people who are living in the place of Mahajanapadas. They are the tribal people who are living in the place of Mahajanapadas. Okay, so what did they do? They have cut all the waste plants. Okay, they have cleared the land, that means patch of land. After clearing, then they have leveled the land and then they have sown the seeds for food grains or kept some saplings for the food grains to grow. Now, what kind of tribal people they were? Okay, the tribal people that time were, okay, farmers, okay, tribals. Here the farmers were the tribals and they were Sakyas, one of the tribal, okay, and other are Malas. Sakyas and Malas, they are tribal community, that means different. For example, we have Hindus, we have Muslims, we have Christians, we have Jains, we have Buddhists, okay, we have Punjabis. Like how we have different religions, in the tribal people also there are some different category people. One are Sakyas and Malas, they are one of the tribal people who were farmers in the Mahajanapadas. So they used to cultivate the land. Now, usually whatever the city or the town is situated towards the wherever the rivers are flowing, these cities or the kingdoms were placed only in those places. Okay, for example, there are many kingdoms which have settled only to the places where they could find river water, because river water helps for agriculture as well as for irrigation purpose as well as for other activities, that means for business also. The places where there is a river, it helps the city or the villages to develop well. So the Mahajanapadas were the place where the river Ganga and where the river Yamunas were passing through. That is the reason why it is known as Gangetic Valley. Okay, Ganga and the river Yamuna passing from the north, that means from the Himalayas, and they have crossed some hills and also touched some parts of Deccan Plateau, and finally they have mixed it into Bay of Bengal. So when they were going, they were collecting some mud. So that mud helped the farmers as farmers. So here farmers in Mahajanapadas are no one. They are tribal community. So what tribal they are? They are Sakyas and they are Malas kind of tribal people. So they have used this soil and they have grown different food crops. Okay, till here you have understood, no? Now firstly, Mahajanapadas. Now the word Jana, J-A-N-A, Jana. Jana is nothing but people. Jana is nothing but people. In Sanskrit, it is known as people. Okay, in the Sanskrit language, Jana means people. Okay, so what is known as Mahajanapadas means? Mahajanapadas means big cities or villages. Big cities. Mahajanapadas are also known as big Janapadas. Big Janapadas. Mahajanapadas are also known as big Janapadas. Okay, that means a group of such villages or a group of such towns are together known as Mahajanapadas. Now Mahajanapada is not any kingdom name. Okay, that means the group of cities together, group of towns together are known as Mahajanapadas. In these Mahajanapadas, there may be different kingdoms. Okay, for example, India is a country which has 28 states. Okay, or 29 states if you say like that. There are 29 states. So every state has its own name, isn't it? For Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Orissa, West Bengal. Okay, so there are different states, Rajasthan. Okay, so like that. So there are some different states here. So in the same way, see, I'll show you a map of India. So in this map of India, you can see different places here with the names. For example, Kamboja, Gandhara, okay, Matsya, Avanti. There are some places here. So these places are known as Mahajanapadas. That means big kingdoms. Okay, the kingdoms in these places, that means which have people or which have cities or which have towns. So these are known as the big Mahajanapadas, or where group of people are living here. Okay, Janas, group of people are living in small cities or small villages. So group of Mahajanapadas here. Okay, so group of cities or group of towns create one Mahajanapada. You understood? For example, number of students make a class. Number of classes make a school. Number of schools make an education, education system, isn't it like that? So these are different Mahajanapadas. This is a map of India. You will see different historical Mahajanapadas. That means different kingdoms here. Now you understood what is Mahajanapada. Now, in this Mahajanapada, how do we know about the Mahajanapadas? Now, how do we know about them? For example, from today, Britishers, from this day, that means from this day to the some 60 years or some 65 years, we know that the Britishers were there in our country. They have ruled our country. Okay, they were some of our political leaders or the national leaders who fought for our country, who have sacrificed their land for, who have sacrificed their lives for our country. How do we know about them? We know by some of the books as well as the things related to that period. For example, If we talk about Gandhi Jayanti, auspicious day. When we remember Gandhi Jayanti, what comes in our mind first? The great personality, Mahatma Gandhi. So when we just think about him, we just imagine that he is working on the charkha, isn't it? Or he might be walking with the lathi in his hand, isn't it? So these are the things that are related of that period. So in the same way, when we talk about Mahajanapadas, how come we'll know about the Mahajanapadas? We'll know by the some of the things that were found by the people as well as from the books written during that period. By the books written by that period as well as by the things that were found. So there are some researchers who find such things. Archaeologists are the people, I have told in the previous lessons also. Yes, archaeologists are the people who find different things, okay, different historical things that belongs to historical things. So when they find a historical thing, they by their knowledge, they can understand to which year it belongs to or to which kingdom it belongs to. They can just, with their knowledge, they can answer it. Okay, so there are some archaeologists, they have excavated, that means they have exhibited, there are some things that belong to the people in the Mahajanapadas time. Okay, they found some mud the vessels that are made of mud, vessels that are made of potter, that means what is clay pots and all, maybe some ornaments of some woman who has worn in that Mahajanapada's time. So all these things were found by the people of archaeologists, and they have exhibited all these things. Okay, and as well as from the books that were written by the people during that period. Okay, for example, Mahabharata. You and I were not there to see the Mahabharata, no? So Valmiki and the Vedavyasa, they have written about the Mahabharata, the epics of the situations, what happened that time. So that is the reason why we can know today. So what has happened during Ramayana, what happened in Mahabharata, isn't it? So in the same way, what happened in Mahajanapadas, who were there, what was the system, everything was written in the books. So no, there are some books which were written by people of our country as well as from the people from other country. So there is a country known as Greece. Okay, Greece. So there people, even they have, when they have come to India to visit, they have written about the Mahajanapadas in the books during that time. Okay, now we can and also, so there are some places where we'll see the Mahajanapadas related things in the places of Pataliputra. Okay, we'll see the place of this New Delhi places. In the place of New Delhi, we find next Ataranji Kheda, okay, Kausambi, okay. So all these are places. Kausambi is a place in Allahabad, okay. One place in this Hastinapur. Hastinapur is in New Delhi, okay. We'll talk about Pataliputra, okay. So all there are all these places where you can find different Mahajanapadas. So whenever you visit to such places, just try to know from the guides or try to know from your parents about the history of some those particular places, so that whenever you go, you feel proud about you are experiencing such things. And please do check the exhibiting things, what they have exhibited, what they are keeping, so that whatever the previous generation people have used, you can see them. Okay, so use the opportunity. Okay, let's go into the class again. So there are some places. So just now I told about the Pataliputra, about the Kausambi, about Hastinapur, Ataranji Kheda are some of the places where this Mahajanapada kind of group are found, that group of kingdoms were found. Okay, now we'll talk about the politics here. Now we'll talk about the politics, or how did the people used to live in that time. Okay, so now in the present day democracy, we choose our own government, isn't it? We choose our own government through votes and elections, isn't it? Now, in the present day, we choose like that. So, in those days also, there may be some administration work. Just I have shown an administration. So, there may be some administration work there. So, who has to look after the administration there? Maybe the rich man of the village, isn't it? The rich man of the village will be the head of the village, isn't it? The person who is having so many lands will be the rich man of the village. So usually he will be the headman of the village, isn't it? Now, so in the Mahajanapadas, what happened is, people who had many lands for agriculture, usually for agriculture. So those people, that means those rich landlords are known as Grihapatis. The rich landlords are known as, landlords or landowners. Okay, I'll write landowners for you. Okay, landlords or landowners, they were known as Grihapati, or also known as Gahapati, Grihapati or Gahapati. So that means, who are they? They are the rich landowners in the cities or the villages there. So they had a lot of lands with them. So what they used to do, they used to give away their lands, or they used to work with these lands, so that they used to cultivate along, they used to cultivate different crops along with their family members. So these landlords or these landowners are known as Grihapatis or Gahapatis. Now, sometimes they used to till their own land, that means they used to grow their crops by their own with the help of the family members. Sometimes they used to keep some workers, they used to appoint some workers. Now, who are their workers? Workers like slaves or dasis. Workers like slaves or dasis. Now, people in those days who have done mistakes, they were kept in the prisons. No, now for example, now whoever has done some crimes, we put them into the jail. But in those days, these people were used as a dasis. That means slaves. That means workers. Okay. we have now domestic workers at our home. In the same way, these rich landlords or the landowners, they used to keep the people like dasis or the slaves to work for them, to work in the fields, to work for them at the home. Okay, so every work will be done by them. Okay, now these people, these headmen people, are so rich that they will be like, for example, a group of children will be there in the class, isn't it? But there will be one class leader, so he'll be head of the class, isn't it? So in the same way, so the landowner will be the headman for the village. The landowner will be the headman of the village. So this headman will be decided by the king from the kingdom. There will be a particular kingdom, no? There will be a kingdom in every Mahajanapada. There will be one or other kingdom. So there will be the king. The head of the kingdom will be the king. The king will decide who will be the headman. So whoever is having number of lands will be the headman of the village. Now this headman of the village can take any decision for the welfare of the people or welfare of the village. Can go and collect taxes from the people. Or collect taxes from different farmers. Now what are taxes? Taxes are the amount collected from the people. Okay, they collect taxes from the people from the village, and they also give any work for the people who are living in the village. So this is their work, and they have to answer all these things to the king who is in the kingdom. So every time when they see, for example, you in the class, your friend is a class leader now. Next time what you feel, I can also be a class leader. What you want, even you try to impress the teacher with some good marks or with a good discipline, isn't it? In the same way, in every Mahajanapadas, there are different landlords or different landowners. So every time what they do to just try to get a chance from the king, even they try to own more and more lands. You understood? They try to buy more and more lands. So if they have more lands, what will happen? They can be the headman of the village. You understood? For example, class teacher, being a class teacher, if I am the king, so I will be appointing the head of the class, the class leader. So here, who is the class leader? The landowner. So who are the people? Other people like the class, there are people in the class, no? There are the students in the class, there will be one class leader. I am the king, for example, I am the king, I will be appointing the head. So who is the head here? The class leader. So who is class leader here? The landowner. He has to look after everyone in the village. So the class leader has to look after every student in the class, isn't it? So he can take the decision, he can collect the taxes from the people. This landowner can collect taxes from the people, as well as can give any work to the people also. Understood? So this is the work. So next time what other student feels, okay, I should also get a chance, I'll ask teacher or I'll impress teacher with good marks or with good discipline, or I'll behave very nice to the teacher so that I will also get a chance. In the same way, the other landowners also try to buy more and more lands. Who buys more and more lands will get an opportunity to become the headman of the village. You understood this concept? Okay, so this is about the landowners. Now, in those days, usually the farming lands, usually the agricultural lands, people in the village, most of them were potters, okay, who make mud pots, potters, weavers, who are weavers? People who weave clothes are known as weavers. They are some blacksmith, okay, blacksmith means people who work with the iron are known as blacksmith. Okay, so for all these people, and there are some farmers also, as usual, they are farmers also. So blacksmith will prepare the things made of iron as well as bronze also. This blacksmith starts making the things which are made of iron, mostly iron, and make some required things for the farming. He makes some sickle, okay, some things that are required for the farming. Some instruments that are required for farming, this blacksmith makes, because in those time, this iron is considered as the, iron has a great importance during that time, okay. So mostly this blacksmith makes those kind of things, and this potter, you know what potter has done in those days? He has prepared different types of pots, as well as he has also prepared pots which are of grey mud pots also, which are grey in, like grey mud pots, okay. Those grey mud pots are very much finest mud pot. okay, and those mud pot also have different designs on that, okay. So those are very fragile. That means you just if you just use so harsh, it will even break. So that much beautiful art was done on the vessels as well as on the pots. So I'll show you in the picture. I'll show you, and here the people who are weaving, the weavers. So weavers in the village, they weave different beautiful clothes, which usually the rich people or the rich landowners or landlords, the kings and queens usually they used to wear this. Okay, so they are different people. They are potters, they are weavers, and they are blacksmith. Okay, they are farmers in the village. So everyone will be working under the landowners. Directions only. Okay, now so I'll show you a picture of a vessel that people in those days they used to use this. See children, this is a vessel here. See, this just like a cup here. So it is a gray mud, okay, gray painted mud, okay, gray painted mud. So they have used this and they have made a vessel, so which was designed with different pictures here, like different designs was there here. See, understood? So this was beautifully done by them, and the clothes were the finest clothes were made by the weavers that time. So usually the land owners and the kings and queens used to wear such clothes. Okay, so these are the people who used to work under land owners or land headmen there. Okay, so this was the class, the emergence of kings and republics. So in this class we have learned about the Mahajanapadas, we have learned about the administration, we have learned about the tribal people, the Sakyas and the Mallas, and we have learned about the landowners. They are the Grihapatis and the Gahapatis, and we have learned about the people who work with different things. That are these are vessels, okay. So and we will be learning about the cities of Mahajanapadas as well as the other community, that means the other kind of a ganas, that means other kind of the gana sangham I have written. We'll learn about this in the next part of the lesson. For any more doubts and queries, please ask us immediately. We'll meet up in the next upcoming class. Till then, bye children. Thank you. Have a nice day.